Thank you. is there.
Who I am is not the question.
I am Atris, Jedi Master. The last historian of the Jedi. The last of the Jedi.
Those are titles, words you cling to as the darkness falls around you.
You are that which has attacked the Jedi. You are Sith.
Sith is a title, yes, but like you, the title is not who I am. It is not what I believe. For you, it is different. Know that there was once a Darth Traer, and that she cast aside that role, was exiled, and found a new purpose. But there must always be a Darth Traer, one that holds the knowledge of betrayal, who has been betrayed in their heart, and will betray in turn. You have bathed in knowledge of the Sith. But there is not enough truth in such teachings, that it will be a step for you.
How did it happen?
Search your heart. It was never battle that called to you, never battle that called you to fall. Alakor V has touched many things and it casts its echoes still.
Why did she betray me?
You betrayed yourself. Do not blame the exile. And unlike you and I, there is still a chance that one may be saved. The one that you cast out.
Where is the exile? I had thought...
Oh, she will come. But it will be too late to save either of us. It is such a quiet thing to fall, but far more terrible is to admit it. Your mistress awaits. She has much to share with you.
She said you would come here to this place. If you think you can defeat me here, you are wrong. All this collected knowledge, all these teachings of combat and the Force, they're mine to command. And if I must use it to end you, I will. Surrender. You need not die. So I arranged for you to return to the Republic, leaked information of your past, and then waited for the Sith to come. But they did. But you came to Telos against my predictions. Now they are here, I can finally face this enemy and defeat them. Surrender to you, never.
Let us end this.
Echoing with the screams of the Jedi lost to us. Yes, I had thought she was awaiting me at that place, but I see now that she lied. It was not meant for me, but for you.
She has gone there. She is waiting for you to travel to Malachor 5 to finish what you started.
Yes, you are an echo in the Force. A hollow space where it has been wounded. It takes a great act of destruction to create such emptiness. But it can be done. It creates places where the Force is difficult to heal and difficult to find one's way. And you carry it with you, always. Now she seeks to create another echo, a wound in the Force, greater than the one before, greater than the one you caused. It will deafen all touched by the Force until no life is left. You were strong enough to withstand it once, but few have your strength in such matters, especially if they are unprepared. I do. But she needs you. If you choose not to follow, she will murder herself at the heart of Malachor. She seeks the death of all Jedi, all Sith, and the death of the Force. It is madness. It is impossible. But she believes you are the key. There are places in the galaxy dead to the Force where nothing lives, where the echoes travel forever and do not reach their destination. And these places may be created even for the simplest of errors, the slightest of motions. One person at the right place, at the right time, can change the face of the galaxy. She is willing to sacrifice herself at the heart of that graveyard world for you. The choice others have made in the past, it is because I care for you. But I suspect that you alone hold that place in her heart. And that is why you are the only one who can stop the destruction to come.
Save yourself. have here. I didn't believe it when Lino reported the Ebon Hawk at dock, but I guess it really has. Though given the trouble we've been having, maybe I shouldn't be surprised to see you. Lieutenant Wren, Sith forces have breached the module and are attempting to pen us up in the compound. All right, follow me. Came out of nowhere. A fleet of warships dropped out of hyperspace, and before we could scramble fighters to intercept them, we were under attack. There were Sith fighters everywhere, and the few flights we sent out were barely launched when the bombardment began. We did our best, but we couldn't stop the landing craft that followed the initial wave. We couldn't hold back the Sith troops. We chose to retreat and began the evacuation instead. Then there's also the fuel situation. Because we don't have enough fuel.
We'll try to make the best of what we have left.
The Sith numbers seem limitless, but we haven't lost all hope. We've heard reports that we might be receiving some assistance.
A squad of troops sent by Queen Talia are currently trying to keep the Sith from sabotaging the station's fuel system.
Does this mean you won't be putting us into force cages again?
If you need to get to the Ravager, then you're gonna have to fight your way to the shuttle from here to the entertainment module, then make your way to the docking shuttle. Good luck.
I must leave you for a time to gather my Mandalorian warriors. Don't worry about...
Men, the Sith are trying to hold us up in this compound. We need to break through or our reinforcements won't be able to move out. Now let's punch a hole in this Sith barricade.
Progress against the Sith line. After they established their position, they brought out their turrets. They've been devastating our numbers. We managed to take a few out, but they just keep unloading more of them to replace the destroyed ones. It's up to you to help us throw them back. We gotta get them cleared out of here, and then we're ready for one last charge. All right! Everyone provide covering fire for the Jedi, then advance on the Sith positions. We'll be right behind you. Good luck.